Hello, dear fans. I know I have a sore throat, dear friends and subscribers, but because of your cooperation and encouragement to the show, I'm always there here to talk on this particular daily cricket show of mine called Cricket Happenings. So on this today's Cricket Happenings show, on a bit of a sober note, I would say, well, first, let's congratulate the India A team. We are talking about the tri-series that was played today. It was the finals of the tri-series. You know, Australia opted out of the tri-series, and Afghanistan joined them. And it was absolutely, the writing was on the wall, and one knew that India and South Africa A would be the ones who would be contesting. But well, what has come up is something that India will be very proud of, as India A defeated South Africa A on their own turf in the finals of the tri-series today. What a victory for the Indians. Shreyas Iyer redeemed himself with a wonderful knock. He showed what a talent he is, Shreyas Iyer, with this particular knock that he played. 267 for 7 for South Africa A, and India A did it in a very convincing fashion by 7 wickets. Shreyas Iyer, 114 unbeaten runs of 131, that is 11 fours and 4 sixes. V. Shankar gave him admirable support to score 72 as well. So congratulations to India A team, actually winning the finals against the South Africa A in the tri-series finals in Pretoria. The other match, well, we have some matches to look at. The two games which are happening between Kent and the West Indies, where West Indies managed to draw the match against Kent, which I'll be talking about. And also we'll have a look at the CPL. There was one match played yesterday where the Trinidad Knight Riders actually won the match by 4 wickets, with some very good display of bowling from the spinners, I would say, from the Trinidad Knight Riders. Shadab Khan, I'm trying to see whether it was, no, it was in fact Shadab Khan, yes, it was Shadab Khan bowling very well. In fact, he picked up a few wickets. In fact, Shadab Khan in the first innings, in fact, all about the spinners, Shadab Khan, Sunil Nareen, and was the one who were very, very effective bowling from them. And also, in general, the Trinidad and Tobago bowlers did a good job. And then the batting took over, and Shadab Khan showing his all round performance here, which was wonderful to see, and he was the one who actually was named player of the match. So definitely some batting skills available with Shadab Khan, this very wonderful all-rounder from Pakistan. So that's as far as the Caribbean Premier League. So we're going to have a look at all this, and then look at some general cricket headlines here. So first, I'm going to talk to you about the finals, the tri-series final between, it was contested by India A, South Africa A, and Afghanistan A in South Africa. And Afghanistan A finished with no victories, and India A and South Africa predictably clashed in the finals of the tri-series. And let's see what happened. So the South Africa A were the ones who batted first. They put on 267 for 7 of the 50 overs, the feature being a century coming from Farhan Bahardeen. Farhan Bahardeen, unbeaten 101, nurtured the team to 267, 114 deliveries and unbeaten one at that, 4 fours and 3 sixes. Got support from Dean Pretorius at the end of the innings, where Dean Pretorius slammed 58 of 61 balls with 5 fours and 2 sixes. Other than that, Henry Davids was out for 20 of 27 deliveries, 3 fours. Reza Hendricks out for 5 of 12 balls with 1 four. Klassen, who made a century in the last match, was out for 6 of 9 balls with 1 four. Kyle Zondo made 39 of 61, 2 fours, 1 to Mulder. Fungiso, 11. Patterson, not around 14, he had 4 fours. 267 for 7, it was all thanks to, in the main, to Siddharth Kaul and Shardul Thakur, the frontline seamers who did the trick for India A. 10 overs, 3 for 52 for Shardul Thakur. Siddharth Kaul, 9 overs, 1 made in 255. Basil Thumpi, 7 overs, none for 53. A bit costly today. Shankar, 4 overs, none for 18. Akshar Patel, 10 overs, none for 47, and Chahal, 10 overs, no maiden, none for 42. So 267, and India did not have a good start. They lost both the openers pretty quickly. Dalla was the one who did the damage when he picked up the wicket of Samson for 12 of 22 fours, and Karun Nair was dismissed cheaply for 4 of 8 balls with 1-4, which really said that India were in trouble chasing 267 at 20 for 2. But what a partnership. Shreyas Iyer, with some excise, an exciting stroke player as we all know, brought the strokes out into the open by playing beautifully. And also V. Shankar gave him tremendous support. And V. Shankar, as you know, he likes to play very aggressively. But both really understood the situation and put up their best show there. Shreyas Iyer was not out on 140 when the victory came up. 131 balls, 11 fours and 4 sixes. V. Shankar making 72. V. Shankar has been very consistent. 72 of 86 balls with 9 fours. Manish Pandey, the captain, the Mr. Consistent, I would say, the Mr. Captain Consistent of the India A team. What a knock from him. He chipped in with 32 in a very sedate manner, giving all the strike to Shreyas Iyer, because I'm sure Shreyas Iyer was viewing the ball in a big manner there, and Manish Pandey just allowed him as much support as possible, playing unbeaten 32 of 38. That was just 1-6 into that. And Manish Pandey, the captain, as you know, is the victorious captain. But I also have to say that Manish Pandey has been captain consistent. I mean, look at his scores. I mean, no wonder he was named man of the series, and rightly so. Manish Pandey, I think the way, the consistency that he has shown, well, I'm sure he's someone, we know that he's a part of the India, where he has already made a century as well in one day internationals, as we all know. But Manish Pandey, I think he has really, really picked the selectors' interest here, no doubt about it. Patterson, 8 overs, 2 minutes, not 42. Dalla, 8 overs, 249. Pretorius, 1 for 51, fouls 35 for the leg spinner Mulder. I think he saw 9.5 fouls, 141. Shamsi was really taken to the cleaners. 8 overs, hit for 52. So, player of the match went to Shreyas Iyer, player of the series went to Manish Pandey, and thus the tri-series in South Africa ended with India A being the proud victors, and congratulations to them. Now, the next match that I'm going to look at is going to be the Kent versus West Indies match. We are talking about the tour match that is happening, and West Indies actually drew the match. As far as yesterday, as you know, Kent batted, and you know, Dixon played a good knock, which I've already spoken about. Haggett made 29. Gidman today made 42 with 6 boundaries. Billings, Sam Billings, 25. Strong batting lineup here. As far as the bowling is concerned, as Alexander Joseph, 472, 221 for Brathwaite. West Indies in there, in fact, 331 for 9 declared. So West Indies batted in the second innings. Well, Hartley was once again amongst the wickets, and making his debut in this particular fixture. I think Hartley has really bowled his heart out. 2 wickets for him. He got Brathwaite very quickly. Then he picked up the wicket of Shai Hope as well for 30. Powell made 23-9. It was Salman Hetmir, the under-19 player, who was a part of the under-19 West Indies World Cup winning team. Did a fine job being unbeaten on 43 of 39 deliveries. 1-6. Blackwood was not reading, continuing his consistency of 37, 1-4, 1-6. And the match ended in a draw. Hartley had 244. So the next, it was Crawley who was making the first class debut, not to Hartley. I'm sorry about that. And then let's have a look at the Caribbean Premier League. The Caribbean Premier League, the match that was played yesterday, it was between the Trinbago Knight Riders, which was taking on the St. Lucia Zooks. St. Lucia were the ones who actually batted first. Batting first, they put on 118 for 9 on the board of their 20 overs. And having a look at the batting card here from the St. Lucia Zooks, Charles made 5-9 balls. The highest scorer was Andre Fletcher, 40 of 45. It was 3-4s and 1-6. Kamran Akmal made 17 of 14, 1-4. Marlon Samuels made 9 of 14. Jesse Ryder, too. It was a strong batting lineup, but I think it faltered against the spinners. Darren Sammy, 25. Mayer, 7. McLennan, not. Taylor, 1. Shillingford, not. 118 for 9 was never going to be a good score, and that was precisely the case. If we look at the bowling from the Trinbago of North Riders, it makes some fantastic reading. Peary, 4 was 1 for 15, Beaton, 1 over for 10 runs, was a bit costly yesterday. Shadab Khan was brilliant, 4 was 1 for 16. Sunil Nareen did his job, 1 for 17 of 4. Kevon Cooper, 3 for 21, was amongst the wickets. Bravo had 2 for 33. Trinbago Knight Riders doing a very good job there, the bowlers. And then the Trinbago Knight Riders batting turn came. And we saw how Brendan McCullum started. In fact, Brendan McCullum and Sunil Nareen opened the innings, which is good. Sunil Nareen just hit 1-6, but before Mayers actually captured his wicket. And I have to say that Brendan McCullum hit one ferocious shot at the bowling of Mayers, and Mayer never bowled after that because he probably got a bit riled on that, and he actually bowled a beamer that actually came and hit Brendan McCullum on the neck, and he was talked to by the umpires, and then Brendan McCullum hit some three glorious sixes with tremendous force, scoring 19 of 9 balls before Shane Shillingford, the Rada Morphy, actually scalped his wicket. Munro was also a victim of the bowling of Shillingford for 1. Shillingford was amongst the wickets today. Shillingford was the one who was doing a good job, but unfortunately the St. Lucia Zooks were left with just 118 runs to defend, and that was too few, I would say. But Shillingford did a wonderful job. He picked up the wickets of McCullum, he picked up Munro, then he picked up Dinesh Ramadin by clean bowling him, and Bravo was also clean bowled. So Shillingford was the one who was doing the trick. Bravo 6, bowled by McLennan. And certainly there was some sort of a real stutter as far as the Trinbago Knight Riders batting was concerned, after Shane Shillingford had actually struck with 4 wickets that really put the pressure. But Shadab Khan first did it with the ball, and now showed his all-round skills with the bat here by nurturing the team to victory with a quiet innings of 30 of 33 deliveries, 1-4 and 1-6. Scantlebury Searles was not on 27 with a hard hit 120, 2-4s, 2-6s, as the Trinbago North Riders went and actually won the match, which is good to see. Look at Shillingford's figures, 4 overs, 1 minute, 4 for 22, bowled brilliantly. Taylor, 3 overs, 1 for 21. Mayers taken off after that beamer that he bowled to McCullum, 1 for 10. Samuels, 1 over 8. Leal, none for 22. McLean, 1 for 21. Fletcher bowled 1 overs and for 10 runs. Shadab Khan, very rightly, was named man of the match. So Shadab Khan showing some all-round skills here for his team. Now, the last thing I'm going to look at is some cricket news. As far as cricket news goes, Ravindra Jadeja, with his wonderful bowling that he has been doing in the Sri Lankan series, has been by in ICC rankings, he has been rated as the number one test all-rounder. The news which is the Palakkad test, the third test match which is coming up for Sri Lanka, which should be a formality for them to salvage something out of the third test, the three test series, as India have already won the series. Rangana Herath will be rested for the Palakkad test. So that's the news we are getting. And you know, Glenn Phillips, we are talking about New Zealand. Glenn Phillips is a very hard-hitting batsman, and he has the record of actually scoring centuries in all formats of the game in the local tournaments there in New Zealand. And he has been called by the CPL, the Caribbean Premier League. Jamaica Thalawas has summoned Glenn Phillips to actually join them. So that is something which is coming up. Well, dear fans, subscribers, that's about it as far as today's cricket show goes. It's about time for me to put a lid on this cricket show today by signing off for the day. Thank you.